The lesson from the book of Exodus. In those days the children of Israel came to Elim, where were 12 wells of water, and 70 palm trees, and they encamped there by the waters. And they took their journey from Elim, and all the congregation of the children of Israel came unto the wilderness of Sin, which is between Elim and Sinai. On the 15th day of the second month after their departing out of the land of Egypt, and the whole congregation of the children of Israel murmured against Moses and Aaron in the wilderness. And the children of Israel said unto them, Would to God we had died by the hand of the Lord in the land of Egypt, when we sat by the flesh pots, and when we did eat bread to the full. For ye have brought us forth into this wilderness, to kill this whole assembly with hunger. Then said the Lord unto Moses, Behold, I will rain bread from heaven for you, and the people shall go out and gather a certain rate every day, that I may prove them, whether they will walk in my law or no. And it shall come to pass that on the sixth day they shall prepare that which they bring in, and it shall be twice as much as they gather daily. And Moses and Aaron said unto all the children of Israel, At even, then ye shall know that the Lord hath brought you out from the land of Egypt. And in the morning, then ye shall see the glory of the Lord.
Here endeth the lesson.
Oh, that like as in a figure of thy church, thou didst bless Noah going forth from the ark, and Moses going forth out of Egypt with the children of Israel, so we bearing palms and olive branches may go forth with all good works to meet Christ our Savior, and through him enter into everlasting gladness, who liveth and reigneth with thee and the Holy Ghost, ever one Lord, world without end.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up unto the Lord.
Let us give thanks unto our Lord God.
It is meet and right so to do.
It is very meet, right and our bounden duty, that we should at all times and in all places give thanks unto thee, O Lord, Holy Father, almighty, everlasting God, who art glorified in the counsel of thy saints, being acknowledged by all thy creatures, their only Maker and their God. All thy works do praise thee, and thy saints give thanks unto thee, confessing without fear before the kings and rulers of this world the great name of thy only begotten Son, before the angels and archangels, thrones and dominations, and all the multitude of the heavenly host, do sing the majesty of thy glory, evermore praising thee and saying,
Holy,
Holy, Holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of thy glory. Glory be to thee, O Lord most high. Blessed is he that cometh in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Let us pray. We beseech thee, O Lord, Holy Father, almighty, everlasting God, that thou wouldest vouchsafe to bless and sanctify these thy creatures which thou hast given to spring from the wood of the olive tree, which likewise the dove, returning to the ark, did bear in her mouth, granting unto all them that shall receive the same, that they may obtain thereby protection both in body and soul, and that by thy grace, which in a figure is shown forth herein, we may effectually be healed unto everlasting salvation, through Jesus Christ our Lord, who liveth and reigneth with thee and the Holy Spirit, one God, world without end.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who gatherest together the outcasts, and preservest them whom thou hast gathered, who didst bless thy people when they went forth bearing branches to meet Jesus, vouchsafe likewise to bless these branches of palm and olive, which thy faithful servant shall here receive in honor of thy name, granting that into whatsoever place they may bear the same, the dwellers therein may obtain thy blessing, that being delivered from all adversity, they may ever be defended by thy mighty power, who are redeemed by Jesus Christ, thy Son, our Lord, who liveth and reigneth with thee and the Holy Spirit, one God, world without end.
Amen.
O God, whose wonderful providence has ordained, like even lifeless things, to show forth the dispensation of our redemption, grant over the prince of death, and by the boughs of olive proclaiming that the anointing of the Spirit was come. For the multitude rejoiced to know that even then it was befitting that our Redeemer, having compassion on the misery of mankind, was making ready to fight against the prince of death for the life of the whole world, and by his death to conquer. And thereby obediently to let me, they laid before him offerings to signify both the triumph of his victory and the abundance of his mercy. Therefore we likewise, with sure faith, having in memory their deeds and the signification of the same, humbly beseech thee, O Lord Holy, Father Almighty, everlasting God, that like as thou hast vouchsafed to make us members of the same, Jesus Christ, our Lord, so in him and through him we may win the victory over the powers of death, and be made partakers of his glorious resurrection, who liveth and reigneth with thee and the Holy Spirit, one God, world without end.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who by an olive branch didst command the dove to proclaim peace on earth, vouchsafe, we pray thee, to sanctify with thy heavenly blessing these branches of olive and other trees, that for all thy people they may be profitable unto the attainment of everlasting salvation, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Bless, O Lord, we pray thee, these branches of palm and olive, and grant that as thy people outwardly with their bodies do worship thee, so inwardly in their souls they may serve thee with pure devotion, that they may be victorious over the assaults of the enemy, and be steadfastly unto all good works. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who liveth and reigneth with thee and the Holy Spirit, one God, world without end.
Amen.
Righteousness, and that we may be found